into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Baseball coming up on this Memorial Day. It's the Tigers and the Crimson Tide. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go. And today's starting pitcher, Brady Singer. But Chris, he hasn't exactly been stellar here on his home mound.
Well, I'll say this. Every player wants to perform well at their home ballpark in front of their fans.
That one ripped left field. And that is gone. A shot to left. His first homer of the year. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0. He sent the first pitch over the wall.
Must have dinner reservations because he wasn't wasting any time at the plate in that at bat. With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. One away. Now here is Jared Walsh. Ground ball up the middle. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. And he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there.
With that fastball, even though it's high velocity, you've got to live on the outer edges. When it's right on a tee, right down the middle, professional hitters are not going to have a problem turning it around.
Singer, certainly one of the best strikeout pitchers in the game, and double-digit strikeouts are not out of the norm in his starts. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one is absolutely belted. And out of here!
With this guy's velocity, a changeup is really a break for a hitter. He got a BP fastball, didn't move a whole lot, and he absolutely tattooed it.
Miguel Sano, now in the box, comes up empty with a swing there. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
He wants to give the bullpen the day off and the defense behind them because he knows he can strike anybody out. And the way the guys are swinging, they're trying to lift, trying to get the ball in the air, he's going to take advantage of that.
Aaron Shunk will hit next. Two hits for him in yesterday's game. In there for strike one. There's a process too, right? The way he goes about setting up hitters.
Yeah, and he's coming right at you. He's going to get ahead in the count. And when you're a hitter and you find yourself.
Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. A towering home run. Home run number 5 on the season. It's 4-0.
No matter how this outing ends, that pitch is going to haunt him for a while. An 0-2 mistake. That's supposed to be a pitch out of the zone. He left it in the spot that the hitter could do some damage with, and that's exactly what he did.
Lopez tosses to first, and that'll do it. Bottom half of inning number 1 coming up. The Tigers with the lead in this one, 4-0. Sweet home Alabama. Nick Gonzalez. He's the new shortstop as he comes in as a defensive replacement here. And the pitch. Into center. Allen makes the grab. One pitch, one out. Take a look at the lineup. Of course, one of the best players in the game today, Adalberto Mondesi.
Took a pretty big step last year. Silver Slugger Award in the American League. And now you're on the radar. Everyone knows it. Your teammates know it. They expect a lot from you because of that success. And so there are going to be times where you're going to have to put the team on your shoulders. And I know he's more than capable of doing that.
The next offering misses, and that's ball one. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. And now 2-2. Bounce to the left side. Sends it to Walsh. Here tonight, an efficient start to the home first, 2 away.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Swings through that one, 0-1. up the middle. Now the throw to first on the run. That's the third out. Top of the second. Now at the plate, Nelson Velasquez. Up the middle. Nelson gets it to first. And quickly one away in the second.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front. Rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
Number four. Yadier.
Yadier Molina. Looks at one outside there. Next offering is fouled back.
Well, with this long series, if you can get into the bullpen, exhaust the other team by game two or three of the weekend.
Yeah, when you're talking about a four-game series, there's no question with a good offense, the ability to affect the pitching staff of the following games is a factor.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And fouled off. Stays alive.
You know, you hear about a lot of guys who are two or three sports stars in college. Jackie Robinson, a four sports star. He was a Division I standout in baseball, basketball, football, and track.
And down on strikes. That ends the frame.
Like damn, see her move. Like damn, see her move. She lit, get money too. Like damn, see her move.
Schnell back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Rolled over to third. Candelario on the first. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Batting fifth.
Mickey Lopez up to the plate. Next pitch has popped up. Robinson settles under it and makes the catch. Two away.
Batting six.
Now it's Andrew Benintendi to hit. A guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. On the ground right side. Has some trouble with it. But in time, nice job to stay with it to end the inning. We head on now to the top of the third. The Tigers. Top half of the third inning, and now Jay Allen. First pitch, and he just misses. Righty to the plate. In the air, center field. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. Safe at second with a leadoff double. So, man aboard. And now the first baseman, Jared Walsh. Bounced to the right. On to first. And one away in the top of the third.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
Jimenez batting for the second time. And that's strike one. Stands at third with one gone in the inning. Smash to the left side. To the plate for one. And he'll be safe at first. Nick Gonzalez, the next to hit. Gonzalez having a lot more success on the road this season. Here's your one. Foul ball.
He's getting the barrel to the ball. He's just got to work on that timing a little bit.
That one ripped. And Benintendi able to make the grab. And welcome back as we go to the last of the third. Adalberto Mondesi up to the plate.
The designated hitter.
Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Now the key to his success is getting ahead early in the count. He cannot afford to go deep in the counts. Doesn't have a ton of swing and miss stuff, so he's going to have to work efficiently.
Walsh handles the chance. steps on first for the out.
Batting it, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. One down, base is empty. Back to the mound. To first, and two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third. Stepping in, Jason Dominguez. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Well struck, right field. And forget it. He made him pay for that one, and they cut it to the lead. It's 4-1.
Jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ballgame.
Now here's Bobby Witt Jr.
Now batting, third baseman Bobby Witt.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Two outs. The other way, makes the catch, inning over. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now a 4-1 ball game.
Ooh, you're good, these are my dancing shoes. Bang the town. Ooh, you're good, thought I would dance with you. Might get loud on Friday, but on Saturday.
Back here in Milwaukee, and now the DH, Aaron Shump. Keller back to work.
Aaron
just off the outside edge. And there's a strike.
Goodness, I think he just took the best pitch he's going to see in this at bat. You don't get many like that in that location. I don't know if you take that pitch against any pitcher out there on the mound.
Fires over to Guerrero. One up, one down.
Now batting
Jamer Candelario.
Jamer Candelario.
And first offering is fouled off. Now fly ball to right center. Dominguez sizing this one up. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now batting.
Two outs, bases empty. And now the right fielder, Nelson Velasquez. He's 0 for 1. And that gets down for a base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
That's hard hit in the line. And Benintendi able to make the grab. And that's the third out. Back here at the ballpark, now the number two hitter, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
For Alabama, the first baseman.
Next pitch downstairs, ball one.
Guerrero Jr.
And that's outside.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0.
Oh, and a nice sliding stop. Nicely done for the out. Now it's the shortstop, Fernando Tatis Jr. Grounded out his first time. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, right now this battery is seeing the aggressiveness of the hitters early in the count and often. So got to be real careful that you don't give too good of a pitch, especially early in the count.
Next offering upstairs.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off speed's probably coming.
Next pitch has popped up. Puts it away for the out. There's Cam Gallagher. Year in and year out, this guy an MVP candidate.
Gallagher.
That hits the dirt. Ball one. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a pop-up. Walsh makes the catch, and that'll do it. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the second baseman, Jackie Robinson. That one's in there. It's 0-1.
Jackie Robinson.
And he pumps it a strike. Righty delivers. Now a blast to left center. Way back there. On its way. Out of here.
Really great job of anticipation there. He knows he throws the sinker. That one down in the zone. You're trying to beat it to the spot it's getting to. Well, he won.
Josh Stamont gets handed the rock out of the pen. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper. Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Jimenez at the plate for the third time as he comes up empty there. 0-2 as he waves at that one. He swings and drives one out to deep left field. Back there. And it's gone.
That pitch was intended to stay inside, but it leaked out over the middle of the plate. Hitter waited on it, and he connected just perfectly.
Right-handed reliever. Strike two. Slapped hard the other way, but foul.
Man, he'd like to have that pitch back.
Kicks and deals. That one out to right. Judge is there. And that ends the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Back here at American Family Field, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's a speed threat, Nicky Lopez.
The second baseman.
First pitch way inside, a fastball. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Way high.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
And he walked him.
Ball four.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
This one is smashed down the right field line. Way back there. Fair and gone. He'll circle the bases. His 11th of the year. It's 6-3. They needed that one, Singy.
Indeed they did. They've been fighting to get back into this game, and just like that, they're back in it. When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
And now here is Adalberto Mondesi. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Mondesi.
Kicks and fires. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's one away. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Aaron Judge. Grounded out his first time. Pitch misses inside. 1-0.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
The pitch. And Judge spoils that one. Still only one out here in the inning. And now 2-1. way out front for strike two.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Next offering is down low, and the count's full. And down on strikes he goes. Now two away. So up next, Jason Dominguez.
Now batting, center fielder, Jason Dominguez.
First pitch just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
Next pitch is popped up. Gonzalez makes the catch, and that'll do it. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. And they've doubled up now. It's 6-3.
Sipping on straight glory. Let the vibe slide over me. This beat is a chemical.
And welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. And now, Aaron Shaw. Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way.
Well, he went up there looking to do damage. I think he had his sights set on that pitch. He went and got it and circled the bases.
Righty reliever out of the pen, Bob Feller. The offense will need to be ready for the breaking stuff. He's got a great curveball.
Feller.
The pitch. Ground ball to the right side. And that should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. Not stopping. He's going for three. The throw to third, and he's out trying for three.
The triple is arguably the most exciting play in baseball, and a guy's worked so hard to get around first, to get around second, and to get thrown out at third. Man, you just feel bad for him. On top of that, he was already in scoring position, so you think about how it kind of hurts the team as well.
Bob Feller was only 17 years old when he made his major league debut, and it did not take long for him to make a name for himself. And a foul ball. Next offering is in for a strike. Talking about Feller's debut, he burst onto the scene at his first start. He struck out 15 batters, and he was still in high school. In his fourth start, he racked up 17 Ks. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in a cage hitting off a tee.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
And Feller didn't slow down anytime soon. Led the league in strikeouts for the next four seasons and won 93 games. Now, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging it or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and you're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
Next offering misses. One and one at the belt and fires. And it's fouled away. Next offering is downstairs. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. It's now a four-run lead at 7. Welcome back. John Schaube with Chris Singleton in the booth and leading off the bottom of the sixth, Bobby Witt Jr.
Third baseman, Bobby.
And first offering is fouled off. And that's down and away.
Looking to get something going, this is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
Out to short, Gonzalez gloves it. And save! He busted it down the line for that infield single. Here's Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Vladimir Guerrero
Throw to first. Witt gets back easily. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Here's a 1-1. Out to short, dive, and he's got it. The throw over to Jackie to get one. To first, not in time. Great effort there. So man aboard, one down, and it's Tatis at the plate. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
Racing makes the catch. Two down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
And that one is lifted in the air. Velasquez gets under it. He's got it. And that is out number three. Top of inning number seven. Here's the center fielder, Jay Allen.
Leading off for the Tigers.
And the first offering is fouled off.
Allen.
Jay Glider taking over on the mound. Hasn't pitched in the last 3 days. And a pitch. And a good eye there. And a pitch. And that chance handled. Tosses to first. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Now
and the batter now, Jared Walsh.
Jared Walsh.
And that one fouled off.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
Next offering is in for a strike. The wind of the pitch. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Oh, and two now. Swings and misses. Two way down.
Well, I don't think there's a hitter alive that hasn't at some point succumbed to that pitch right there. It just looks like it's in the zone the entire way. And then the top spin and gravity take over in the blink of an eye. And it's just such a tough pitch to lay off of.
Yoan comes up empty. That's strike two. Bounced up the middle. Tatis handles that chance. Throws to first. Third out, and that ends the frame.
It's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Back here in Milwaukee, set for the last half of the seventh, standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Nicky Lopez. And he hits a ground ball right side. Walsh takes it himself, and a quick out number one. Digging in, Andrew Benintendi, one for two. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
That misses the zone, and it's 1-1. The pitch. And a foul ball left side. And the next pitch is way outside. And he deals. This one in the air, center field. Allen moving under this one. He makes the grab. And there's two down. Two outs, bases empty. Now it's the DH at Alberto Mondesi. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And the righty deals. Swings through that one for strike one. The pitch. And another ball. Two, two down. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. And out of here. So he just clears the wall. His ninth homer of the year. And they're chipping away. It's 7-4.
Recognition early, he saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Two outs, nobody on. Here comes Aaron Judge.
Now batting, right fielder, Aaron.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. There's a strike.
Two strikes to a guy who's already 0 for 1 with the punch out. The only guy in the lineup with that strikeout. But you can't get too relaxed. You still got to make good pitches to get him out.
And a foul ball. He stays alive. The 0-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. But not before they answer back with a solo home run. It's now 7-4. We're at the top of the eighth, and the batter will be the shortstop, Nick Gonzalez.
Leading off for Missouri, the shortstop, Nick
Gonzalez. Leiter back to work. There's a strike. The Y to kick the pitch. Swings through that one for strike two. And the 0-2. On the ground, right side. Lopez tosses to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. So now the DH spot, Aaron Shunk for the fourth time tonight. And first offering is fouled off. And here it comes. And a big swing and a miss. The wind and the pitch. On the ground, right side. Guerrero takes it to the bag. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth.
Now
and now it's switch hitting third baseman Jamer Candelario. One for three. Swings through that one. 0-1. Swing and a miss.
Throwing the ball well, and they need this scoreless inning in relief right here. Been doing a good job keeping him in striking distance.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Racing makes the catch. And that is the third out of the inning. So they turn to Edwin Diaz out of the pen. And he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. And now the center fielder, Jason Dominguez. He's already homered in this game. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Candelario makes the grab. One pitch and one out. So the batting order turns over. Bobby Witt Jr. digs in now.
Bobby Witt Jr.
Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. He can't get there. That should be extra bases. Oh, the throw is wild. Not in time. He's safe.
Fastball pretty much middle, and that's what you fall asleep dreaming about as a hitter. So no surprise he put a great swing on it. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr. now. First offering misses badly for ball one.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some...
Good feed. That's one. On to first, double play, and that's the inning. Back here at American Family Field. Now it's the right fielder, Nelson Velasquez. Fought off foul. Nelson Velasquez. And Elio one. Next offering is outside. Got the back going too soon. It's strike two. The 1-2. And he grounds one back up the middle. Sneaks through. Base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Now Molina at the plate.
Now that.
And that's in there for strike one.
Molina.
And ball one. Grounder might be two. To Tatis for the pivot. There's one. Relay to first. Double play. Back to the top of the lineup. Now it's the second baseman, Jackie Robinson. Swing and a ball lifted in the air. Left field. Pretty well struck. And that one is gone.
He's putting on quite the show at the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with this swing, and he's just not missing right now. Three homer game, man, it's so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
Stays alive.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
The pitch. Tap to first. Guerrero handles. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now an 8-4 score. Back here at the ballpark, and here is Fernando Tatis Jr.
Alabama, the shortstop.
Diaz, back to work. Ball one, no strikes. Activity in the bullpen. Chester Reed up and loosening in the pen. Brooks getting loose as well. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah, little slider action.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. That one back. Go!
The pitch, but once he did, was quick enough to get it in play with some authority. He got that up and out of here.
Nolan Riggs gets the ball now, trying to protect this lead.
The catcher, number 36.
Now here is Cam Gallagher. First pitch, not close.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Next pitch is outside.
He hasn't wanted to challenge him. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. Grabs it barehanded. Over to first. He's in there.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go. And throw, you know?
Yeah, no question.
And now, Nicky Lopez. And the first offering is not close. And the pitch. On a line, base hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out. Benintendi to the plate. He's already homered here in this one.
Benintendi.
First offering misses the mark.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
right-hander deals. Swing and a miss. And that is strike one.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Now a rip into left center. Nice grab on the run. Runner tags up for third, and he moves up 90 feet. Runners at the corners now. One away. Adalberto Mondesi getting ready to hit. And first offering is fouled off.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And now just two outs away.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Over to first, and he's saved. Now this one gets away at the plate. Nothing happening on the bases, though. Rocketed out towards right center. And that ball is out of here. Home run number 10 on the year. And they tie it up. It's 8-8.
Tells me he would have been ready for a fastball. Just impossible to cover that wide of range of velocity. But he does a nice job picking his pitch, and he gets rewarded for it.
Christy Mathewson will take over here. He's pitching on 2 days rest. Here is Aaron Judge. Good contact guy, good defender.
The right fielder, number 99. Aaron.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Tied at four. And Judge spoils that one. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. In the air out towards right center. Allen racing over to make the catch.
Now batting.
At the plate, Jason Dominguez. This guy has turned into a beast. First pitch, and he just misses.
You don't want to get beat by a fastball in, and he spits on that one.
Out towards right center. That's well struck. And it's off the wall. Throw comes in quickly, but the winning run is now in scoring position, two away. Now, Bobby Witt Jr. This guy, one of the best contact men in the sport as well, outstanding on the defensive end. First offering misses badly for ball one.
Well, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Here comes a pitch. That's out to center field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. All even now at 8 apiece. We're in extras here, and here's the first baseman, Jared Walsh. Foul ball there.
The first baseman, Jared.
The 0-1.
Walsh.
On the ground, right side. Fires over to Guerrero. Walsh retired. Here's Eloy Jimenez. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button. Try to get some more runs and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there. And now the shortstop, Nick Gonzalez. Benintendi is there. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. On to the bottom of inning number 10. We are deadlocked at 8 apiece. And welcome back. On to the bottom of the 10th. Here's a big power threat. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he waves at that one.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
In the air, right field, pretty well struck. That's back. He hits the wall and hangs on. Great catch. Ball back in quickly. Runner holds at third. And now it's going to be Fernando Tatis Jr.
Really good piece of hitting last time. Going to the opposite field.
Out towards right center field. That one's got a chance. He sends one out the opposite way, and they walk it off in extra innings.
You get to extra innings, it seems like every guy is trying to come up with the big swing to hit the homer and end the ball game. Well, he did it. Huge swing of the bat, and we're all heading home.
The final 10-8. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.